Notion can be confusing for beginners and can easily get overcomplicated even if you're a seasoned user. There are so many possibilities that it's easy to want to add every view, database, features, and formulas as possible. However, in this video, we wanted to show you 6 tips on how you can master Notion. If you find this useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So the first tip we have for you is just to start with the basic. So it's really easy to want the most aesthetic setup with all kinds of pages and cards and everything, but actually the easiest way and the best way to actually master Notion is just to start really simple. So if you're just looking for a to-do list, maybe if you're first using Notion for the first time, you can just simply type /checkbox and then create a to-do list. So here you would just type your to-dos, and let's say that you have today, this is what you need to do, and so on. So just using it basically as a basic note-taking app can really start making it easier for you to understand how Notion's pages and blocks work. So here you would type another checkbox, and gradually you can add more to-dos here and so on. And then you could copy your whole setup down here, and then it could be tomorrow, and so on. So it can be just as simple as that you would just have your to-do list like this with checkboxes, and you don't really even bother to use databases. It can also work really well just so that you don't get confused with all the options out there. So this would be our first tip for mastering Notion, is just to really get familiar with, for example, the slash command and using all of these options first before you even get into databases. Our second tip is to use simple databases. So now that we've mentioned to start with the basics and get really familiar with how pages work in Notion, we would recommend you to just use maybe one database at a time and really get familiar with that. So let's say that you have your to-do list now like this. Something you could consider is just simply to type slash and then you would choose a table view database. And let's say that this is now your task list. So all you would need to do is just copy your to-dos, and then you can just simply just drag them in like this, and it would just create them like this already for you. So this is another thing that's really great with Notion, is that you can now delete the ones that you don't need, but basically your whole entire to-do list has been transformed here. So you can just simply drag this over, rename this to done, and you basically have a very basic task list that you have basically replaced your old task list, which was just checkboxes. So this is kind of how we would recommend you to move forward, is just to use simple databases, don't use relations, and really get familiar with even how databases work and start adding new properties, but just be careful that everything you add is only what you need. The next tip we have for you is to build slowly. This is also relevant in this way that if you have now this task list database, and as you're using it, you notice that you want to add a tag here for work. So this is a work task. Rather than adding every single possibility of tags, we would recommend you to only add the tags that you need here so that you're not overcomplicating this by already pre-planning every single tag that you might need in your to-do list, but rather that you slowly build on what you need. So after the tags, let's say that you think, okay, now I need a created date just so that I can keep track of when I created my tasks. Then you can go ahead and click the plus sign here and then look for created time. And now you would have a created time showing up here. So in this case, we would recommend you to refrain from planning everything out at once, but rather just start with your to-dos. Then you would move on to tags, you would move on to created time, and gradually you might even realize once you have 2 databases that you might want to connect them, you can connect them, but avoiding pre-planning and instead building slowly with what you need is one of the best ways to really master Notion. The next thing we wanted to discuss is to focus on usability. So it's really easy to want to use the most aesthetic Etsy templates that are out there with a bunch of photos and different kinds of databases all on the page, and it looks really nice, but we think that it should be a mix of the two. So you can add your favorite cover photos, your favorite icons, and really make it your own, but at the same time, make sure to focus on usability. So if you frequently find yourself lost among your pages and you don't know how to get back to your main dashboard and so on, you might want to consider paring it down, simplifying it, and making sure that you really have a usability that you'd like from Notion, because after all, it is a productivity tool and a way to organize your thoughts and your pages. So we highly recommend focusing on usability. The next thing we recommend you to do is to analyze templates. So let's say that you're looking to create a place to handle your notes in Notion. You might want to download a notes template just to check how others are doing it. And then that way you can add your own spin on it and make sure that it's usable for your own needs. So let's say we have this digital notebook template. How we would recommend a user to approach this if they're learning Notion is just to, for example, click one open and check what kind of properties there are and what kind of things are inside. So you want to really analyze this, and one of the best ways to analyze it is just to check what databases are being used. So you can go ahead and click layout and then show database title. So now you can see that the notebooks is here, and then you can also check here what kind of database is being used by going to layout and then showing that this is notes. So there's two databases in this template, notes and notebooks. And then if we open this up, you can now see by opening this one up, layout, that this one is actually also using the notes, but it has this arrow here, which actually means that it's referencing this one. So in this way, you can really analyze the relationship between these two databases. If you open it up, you can also see that there's a relation property here that it's connected to one note here. So in this way, if you start mapping out how the databases are relating to each other, it can really make it easier to understand how it's working. Even for buttons, you can click this one and then see exactly what's going on inside. And you can also click here in the blue dot to see exactly what kind of database templates are being used by going to edit, and you can actually look inside what's happening. And you can also check the sort and the filter options. So even just trying to recreate this based on what you see could be a really great way to learning how templates work and how you might want to actually design your own. So the next tip we have for you is to make sure to use all the learning resources out there. So for example, on our website, we have workshops. So every month we do have live events where we talk about how to create templates from scratch. We also have a blog which explains a lot of concepts as well inside of Notion. So if you're on our YouTube channel, you can go to videos and see all of our videos that we've posted. We generally post around twice a week, so you can expect some kind of tutorial or Notion content relatively frequently. If you want to go to playlist, we also have a learning playlist as well, so you can really get a good view on how to build Notion templates and Notion workspaces. And finally, our best resource in terms of Notion would also be Notion's own website. So if you're inside of Notion's website, if you go all the way down, you can go to the Help Center. And inside the Help Center, it basically has all of the documentation. So you can click Start here, and you can see videos and information about various things. And especially important might be the database section. So you can see all kinds of information relating to relations and rollups and so on. So these can be really useful resources, especially because it's coming directly from Notion. So obviously there's a lot of creators out there creating really good resources for Notion, but a huge resource also for us is just to look at Notion's documentation just so that we know exactly what they're writing about their product. So we also recommend checking this out. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in our full Notion Mastery course, we have the link available below. This course can help you learn Notion through a hands-on approach to gain skills that you can use right away. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know. If you have any of your own tips for mastering Notion, make sure to leave a comment below.